when I was a kid.
The world was as big as my imagination, which is pretty big. Only it was imaginary.
We send our love from Earth. We're going to transmit to these two astronauts who are up about 220 miles up there somewhere.
I said, you know, one day there's going to be spaceships up there orbiting the Earth. Then if I said, I'm going to sing for the people up there, and I'm going to meet the crews, well, they would have locked me up right there.
We consider you an explorer just as we are, and we're all targeted toward the same thing, and that's ensuring a bright future for the young people in our planet.
The station is Houston on one.
Houston, we're ready.
No one's ever had a wake-up call like the two astronauts on the International Space Station got this morning.
We read you loud and clear on Space Ground 2.
We would like to say good evening to you all in Anaheim, California.
It was this world of ambition and imagination.
You can't imagine, you know, what's going to happen in your future. So much has happened since those days.
Paul seems so aware of the journey he's taking you on.
It transcends age and it transcends boundaries.
He does tap into your heart. He does grab something in everybody.
I looked at his face, and it really tells a story. Everything about his life is on his face.
When you watch him, it is your life. You know, it is your life, it's your whole life.
We're all in this together.
It's not an us and them situation, it's all us. That's why we call the tour the Us Tour. It's like if you're a family and you're giving a party, then these are all your guests. And this is the Us Tour, because it's about us, it's about us, it's about us all together. We're all in this together.
Hey, good morning, everybody. It's beautiful all day.
Sunday morning, Q1043. Good morning, Paul McCartney. Hiya, how are you?
How are you?
I'm all right, thanks, yeah.
Paul McCartney, this is the biggest thrill of my life.
Yeah, I'm just driving in to the gig.
How are you doing? We're not worthy!
This is a man so excited to see you in concert tonight, Paul. We can't wait.
I'm just on the radio. Stop now. Yay, all right.
Okay, can you tell we're excited to see you, Paul?
You know what? I'm getting the feeling.
One of the greatest shows I've ever seen, last night at the Garden. Paul McCartney and the band, who is just at the top of his game.
Songs take on a new thing when you play them live to an audience.
As good as it gets, and wow.
We had a lot of fun, actually. The crowd was sensational.
Fourthland Road, many of my formative years were spent at the house.
I think Paul was completely modeled by his mother and father.
They gave me great support growing up.
He had a sense for the straight and narrow and never left him.
My dad was a cotton salesman, my mom was a nurse. Their values were very strong. They gave me a good set of rules. I didn't listen to all of them, as you don't, you know, you're teenage. But eventually they've been the rules that I've live by. I don't really think that I showed any sort of startling promise. I can't remember anyone sort of saying, hey, this guy's a bit of a prodigy. I think I started to imagine there was more out there than my narrow little sphere of reference. We thought we were just getting into it to earn a few bob, to, you know, be famous. But in actual fact, something much more important has happened.
They changed popular music forever.
They gave everybody the license to go someplace else.
That was a particularly big world of energy that I wanted to plug into.
All these years he's been out on his own, always growing. There's something about him that's changeless, and it's profoundly appealing to people.
We'll be right back.
He's an American icon. He means something to us, and we feel like that we have at least a small claim on him. I was in the Staples Center in Los Angeles when he sang, and it was amazing. The whole generation of young people, virtually everybody in the audience was much younger than me, and they were just as into it as I was.
This is the only tour. Yeah, there's touring and touring, you know. McCartney's very special.
Oh, it's the tour!
probably the best crew I've ever worked with. And it's always fun being around people that you can laugh and joke and, you know, let your hair down, so to speak.
Yeah, it all comes from the top with Paul. It's very much hands-on with everybody. It makes everybody feel involved in the team. Just radiates from there, really.
It is us.
Astor is very much bidding for this one, for secret reasons, too. I mean, there are a lot of secret relationships. Two guys just got married last night on the crew. I think four caterers fell in love out here. It's a very us tour.
For me, it's a fantastic thing because really I just started off wanting to do my job, and I love music, so I was in a band and that became the Beatles. And because it was such a phenomenon, it rose us to levels of great fame, which were kind of difficult to deal with in a way, because it's a bit embarrassing. Suddenly you're not just the guy you think you are, you're the person they think you are as well. And sometimes you say, look, I'm just ordinary, you know, I'm just lucky, I write some songs you like. And no, you're not.
Oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah, oh yeah. The magic I'm in love with you. It's easy cause I know. I've imagined I'm in love with you. Many times before, it's not like me.
Maybe many times before. It's unlikely to pretend, but I'll get you. I'll get you in the end. Yes, I will.
Good times and through bad, this man's music has been there.
He's given spirit and life to so many people through his music. It's an extraordinary accomplishment to come from just one person.
His music is a unifying force because he is.
Music is a very powerful healing device because it's part of who we are as humans. Music is the universal language.
You can't define that. You can't define where it comes from.
Why do these combinations of vibrations, why do they affect us so much? How can they really affect our emotions? It's just so special, and it's something to do with the words, it's something to do with the chord changes. I love that. I really love that about what I do.
Of the rice in the church where a wedding has been. Lives in a dream, waits at the window, wearing the face that she keeps in a jar by the door. Who is it for? All lonely people, where do they all come from? All lonely people, where do Kenzie, writing the words of the sermon that no one will hear. No one comes near, look at him working, darning his socks in the night when there's nobody there. What does he get? All lonely people, where do they all come from? All lonely people, where do church, it was buried along with her name. Nobody came. Father McKenzie, wiping the dirt from his hands as he walks from the grave. No one was saved. All lonely people, where do they all come from? All lonely people, where do
when I write a song, I try and reach something in somebody. There's families that come to the show. I can relate to them. It's quite emotional for me, the idea that they're all pulling together, all these generations.
Kind of the sweetest thing once a student said to me, his name was John Paul, and he said, my father named me after the Beatles, and right now we're going through a very difficult time. And he said, I thought if I took this class, I would be able to maybe have something to talk and have in common with my father and be able to get on slightly better terms with him.
For families who have felt fracture, who have felt divisiveness, this is an opportunity to come together under the banner of not only great music, but of music that makes us, when we leave, feel like the world can be the place we want it to be.
Baby, I'm amazed at the way you love me all the time. Or maybe I'm afraid of the way I love you. Baby, I'm amazed at the way you put me out of time. You hung me on a line. Maybe I'm amazed at the way I really need you. Oh,
Let's go and do our bits and pieces right up that way. Yes.
A humanitarian, a living legend. Ladies and gentlemen, Sir Paul McCartney!
I actually cut his
thoughts. Take it down. Yeah. Shake the baby shake. All you gotta do is just stand in one spot. Wiggle around just a little bit. Shake it all right.
It was genius writing, genius recording. It was just ahead of his time.
You're doing it again.
Yeah, we're doing it again.
I'm checking it, really.
I'm checking it.
That's the most fun I had in a couple of months.
You would toast them with us too, which would be really good. If you stood up and said, listen, that was really good, really proud I did that. Yes.
Showtime!
I'm living in a kind of daydream. Apparently, in the old Shakespeare days, the guys used to go on stage and there'd be royalty, like on stage. But they said to each other, break leg.
I like that.
To me, that's everything.
I don't sing that one.
I had this overwhelming sense that somehow through this incredibly easy stage manner, there is a humility that really betrays his incredible celebrity. That somewhere deep down inside him, he must know how important he is to people like me, just another guy that went out and bought a ticket to see him in concert.
You know, certain songs touch you and you bond with those songs and love them, and then to see him that close and look him right in the eyes and he's talking to you, it's overwhelming, life-changing.
I was alone, I took a ride, I didn't know what I would find. Hey, I'm on the road, well maybe I can see another guy.
pictures in.
You know, I'm getting that feeling again, like we're going to have a little bit of fun here tonight. Okay, you will see mysteriously arriving behind me a piano. And before this piano arrives, there is a big hole. And on the second night of this tour, I forgot there was a big hole. And I was chatting away to the audience, I was holding my bass, and I fell backwards into the big hole. Ooh. Yeah. And you know, everything goes into slow motion when that happens. And I'm just, I know I'm going, and I've lost it. So I'm going backwards, and I can just remember thinking, how deep is this hole? Okay, there's a big hole in the stage, and I just fell into it.
Rock and roll!
We've been expecting this to happen.
Yep.
And it happened in Tampa!
You saw it first!
Ow!
Yeah!
It's okay, it's filled now. Come to work. If you've got a good team,
that you can relate to and you can enjoy it, then it's us.
Well, we have really got the best team, yeah. Yeah. And the thing is, it's grown up through the years.
Well done.
Well, day of jolly good fellows.
You keep coming back. Fools. I've warned them.
I do my show, I get this beautiful feedback, I get a great feeling, I feel that all my people feel great. Yeah.
Speech, speech.
Couldn't think of a better place to be. This plane, you guys, you keep me young.
They know what the vibe is. We're all trying to just give that audience something to remember.
Who knows how long I've loved you? Oh, I love you still. Will I wait a lonely lifetime? If you want me to, I will. For if I ever saw you, I didn't catch your name, but it never really mattered. I will always feel the same. Love you forever and forever. Love you with all my heart. Love you whenever we're together. Love you when we're apart. And when at last I find you, your song will fill the air. Sing it loud so I can hear you. Make it easy to
guy looked at me.
He did.
Mike? Sorry, I had someone do eye contact there. That guy there.
That man there.
He's been.
I have my retina burner with me.
I well remember writing this next song in the front parlour of our little council house in Liverpool, looking through the lace curtains onto the road, 24th Lynn Road.
Well, don't you know that tomorrow may rain? It's such a short little song, you know, I just want to keep going, keep going. So don't you know that tomorrow may rain, so I'm gonna follow the sun. Well, don't you know that tomorrow may rain, so I'm gonna follow the sun. When the Discovery space mission went up to the International Space Station, it was a very historic mission. We're very proud to say that on the morning that NASA actually told them that they were cleared to re-enter into the Earth's atmosphere and come home, they actually woke them up with one of our songs. So it sounded something like this.
Good morning, Discovery. And the wake-up music this morning just about says it all. It's a day for sunshine, and it's a day for feet on the ground.
Thanks, Shannon. We sure hope that we get our feet on the ground today.
And we do too, Wendy.
This was fantastic. They walked on as proud as punch, you know, all looking great. I could see by the expression on their faces, they were really buzzing as well as us. I was so excited. And I must say, as I went along the line and sort of thanked them all, I must say, when I got to Wendy, she was welling up. She was pretty emotional. Because it was a really emotional moment, you know, suddenly, there they were, not only back on Earth, but like wrapping up this whole story on stage with us. That was great. There was the Discovery crew. Yeah, man. It was fabulous.
It was one of the interesting thing happens when you get out on a tour. People start bringing signs. And, you know, when you're doing a new song like that, you're trying to concentrate on the chords and the melody and the words and putting it all together, trying to stay focused. And then a sign will appear. And you're drawn to it. You've got to look at it. And your mind splits in two. And one half of your mind is saying, don't look at it, don't look at it. Focus, chords, words, keep going. Think, don't you? But the other half of your mind's going, yeah, well, look at it, read it. What's it going to mean? And so you do. So, I tell you, it's not easy. They're trying to put it all together and you're looking up there saying, my mother saw you at Candlestick Park.
No!
Your day breaks, your mind aches, you find that all the words of kindness linger on, and she don't love and needs you. She wakes up, she makes up, she takes her time and doesn't feel she has to hurry. She don't love and needs you, and in her eyes you see nothing, no sign of love behind the tears. Think she needs you.
We met him in person, we wouldn't really actually touch him that much.
We're a Beatle family. Yeah.
Good taste.
It's amazing. Is he still singing in the same key? They say
that same original key.
Really? That is nuts.
I swear, he sounds better with age.
If there's been any influence in my life other than, you know, my family and my religion, it's been Paul McCartney.
Bing, bing, Maxwell's silver hair ringing down on his head.
Wouldn't it just be nice to say thanks?
Yeah.
That's all. I don't want to say, you know, gee, Paul, I love you, and, you know, let me tell you about my life, because I'm sure everybody feels that he's, you know, their best friend and that they know him so well, but to just be able to say thank you.
Those girls screaming and crying in the old Beatle videos. They're just crying, they're screaming, and it's like, I went to the concert and I was like, you know, like trying to hold back my tears, but you can't help it. You just get, it's so powerful.
And let's face it, he still looks good too, doesn't he?
He's still hot.
We're ready to go.
We're ready to see Paul.
All right, let's go.
You think they'll figure out where we're going with our shirts on?
It's like the classical music of our time, you know?
He doesn't condescend to his audience. He really embraces them. He's happy to see grandparents in that audience. He's happy to see six-year-olds. He doesn't deny them his music. He's not egotistical about what he's created to the point that it is supposed to be sophisticated.
Paul McCartney does not laugh at you for having that nostalgia. You know, he doesn't scorn it. He endorses it, loves it, and he's the greatest ringleader, you know?
You see multiple generations of people crying, singing along with the entire concert. Not one or two songs, the entire concert. That's a profound thing right there.
We have a traveling crew of around 70 guys.
Watch out for the workers.
He's right up front. He's a very personal guy. He's very accessible to the crew and always wants to know all the guys' names and the gals, and he sets the tone.
We come in and mark the floors at 7 a.m. Then 8 o'clock, we do a full-on load-in. Everybody has their job. Everybody comes together, gets it done.
Good down here.
Straight up. Send it up, up and away.
Technology makes things easier and hotter all at the same time.
Hey, Rick, fuel power to spot 6.
The stage is pretty cool. A lot of engineering and a lot of advanced work goes into these shows.
We're good.
The stage usually rolls into place, and within 5 hours,
I get the show clock running, get everybody into their show mode, and make sure everybody's in their positions. We get rolling, and then I'm there, not too far from from the deck. We keep an eye on everything during the show, make sure nothing goes wrong.
I'm fixing a hole where the rain gets in and stops my mind from wandering where it will go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. I'm filling the cracks that ran through the door and kept my mind from wandering where it will go. They disagree and never win. Wonder why they don't get in my door. I'm painting the room in a colorful way, and when my mind is wandering, there I will go. Whoa, whoa, whoa. And it really doesn't matter if I'm wrong, I'm right. Where I belong, I'm right. Where I belong. Silly people run around, they worry me and never ask me why they don't get past my door. I'm taking the time for a number of things that weren't important yesterday, and I still go.
History gives us artists. Only once in a while of that caliber, where they can bridge generations, they can bridge continents. When I think of Paul McCartney and I think of his legacy, I think of Bach, how Bach was the culmination of a Baroque period, how Beethoven single-handedly changed us from classical to romantic. And then you have the whole concept of Paul McCartney and his legacy, where he took us to the ultimate of pop music in the 60s and 70s, and then he changed it. And what's amazing is that he changes it in such a way that it's reflective of the society that we all live in. And as we grow and we all relate to that society, and you get us into this concert venue, he touches upon different parts of that society. The society when we were young, when we were middle-aged, and when we were older. And it's cross-cultural, it's cross-generational, it's an amazing event.
Benny Lane, there is a barber showing photographs of every head he's had the pleasure to know. And all the people that come and go, stop and say hello. On the corner is a banker with a motor car. The little children have it in behind his back. And the banker never wears a mask. Penny Lane is in my ears and in my eyes. There beneath the blue suburban skies I sit and meanwhile. In Penny Lane there is a fireman with an hourglass, and in his pocket is a portrait of the queen. He likes to keep his fire engine clean. It's a clean machine. We see the banker sitting waiting for a trim. And then the fireman rushes in from the pouring rain. Very strange. Penny Lane is in my ears and in my eyes. There beneath the blue suburban skies I sit. This is the kind of way I want to travel at home. I just don't like rush hour, and I like these guys. I want 6 motorcycle cops with me at all times.
Greetings, St. Paul! Greetings, New York City! DC! Detroit City! Denver, Colorado! Philadelphia! Get back in Chicago!
Great to be back here.
It's commuting, it's the same as what everyone does, only we commute by plane.
Watch them!
Hey!
Oh,
hey.
Oh yeah!
seven levels.
Seven levels to this tour.
You've been tooling around that thing today?
I smell very hot bricks.
You've got a valet parking job now.
Bit of extra.
Bit of an indoors existence this year, inside a car, inside the hall, inside a hotel. And I keep sort of thinking, logically looking at it, I should be sort of fed up with it, and it should be getting harder, but it isn't. And I suppose some of the reasons are, like you say, the transport, the hotels are better, dressing rooms much cozier than it ever was. But I don't think it is that. I think it just is that I still have a passion for what I do, and when we get it right with this band, it sounds really good.
Too many people going on through.
Has this special, unique gift that he captures somehow the essence of what human beings have to go through because he himself is a great human being. You know, it has to come from a person who has that kind of caring about humanity in his heart. Let it be.
And in my hour of darkness, she is standing right.
I do believe, truthfully, that music does heal.
It actually acts upon the biological processes of the person.
Certain notes make you feel better. Certain combinations of tones make you feel better.
Heart rate will change. Brain waves change.
There's McCartney's calling card. That's his trademark. It's all of these pitches that just keep swirling out, and they make us feel good.
It's part of who we are as humans. When you think of the human body, first of all, everything about us is musical. Our heart rate is rhythm. Our brains are rhythm. Our breath is rhythm. Music is a very powerful healing device.
Music is an amazing thing. How it can be uplifting, how it can be soothing, how it can totally change your energy, how it can make you feel better when you feel bad.
Is the most powerful thing that we have. When the mind shifts with the music, the possibilities with the music are endless.
You know, 8546.
Okay, go ahead, and if you guys want to...
Got 13 minutes to LOS.
Space program, we have what we call Wake Up Music. Today's going to be the first time that we've ever done that live from a concert to space.
Talk about bringing people together. I mean, this was actually talking to two guys who were orbiting the Earth over 200 miles above us. And we were actually just gonna talk to them as if they were on the end of a telephone line.
They should be waking up right about now.
As you probably know, we're gonna do something really special tonight. We're gonna transmit to these two astronauts who are up in the International Space Station right now, about 220 miles up there somewhere. Are you ready?
It looks like ISS would be just off the coast, west of California, Anaheim.
A couple of clocks with the timeline for the crew. The AO event is actually the countdown clock to this McCartney event.
The dish antenna slews. It follows the satellites as we orbit the Earth at 5 miles per second. Tracks to a series of communication satellites that NASA runs. So we blend it all together and get it patched up to the particular client, in this case, Paul McCartney and the audience in Anaheim.
It was so cool, you know, for me to be able to, because we were all excited. You know, my whole crew, we got about 140 guys working here, and girls. And everyone was, we were really excited about this. You know, it's a big thing for us.
This is very cool. They're actually pumping the video into McCartney's teleprompter on the stage. So they're producers who will, okay. Who will pump it out to the big screens at the venue.
Okay. 2 minutes, Scott Chase, that's 2 minutes. Let me know if he can take it. I'll get the officers.
And station, this is Houston on one. Video looks good. Stand by for a call on two.
Hi, Houston, we're ready.
And Bill, we read you loud and clear on Space Ground 2. How us?
Loud and clear.
They could look out the window and see the concert. Good view.
Fantastic.
We will be live to 22,000 people.
22,000 screaming. Yeah.
That was very exciting because people at NASA, you know, were split second timing and talking to the space station. They were talking to us. And really all I had was a guy in the pit. He's got a card. So it says, 6 minutes left. I'm going, we are so high tech. I love us.
We're good to go.
We are going to go now to the International Space Station. Check it out. Here we go.
There they are. Yay!
Bill and Valeri, we have a greeting for you from all the audience here. We'd like to wake you up with a little bit of English tea. Here we go. Would you care to sit with me for a cup of English tea? Would you care to sit with me? Sunday morning, miles and miles of English garden stretching past the willow tree. Lines of hollyhocks and roses listen most attentively. Do you know the game croquet? That adventure we might play. As a rule, the church bells chime when it's almost supper time. Nanny makes very cakes on a Sunday morning.
We are honored again that you have joined us. We consider you an explorer just as we are. Your venues of exploration, of course, have ranged everywhere from music to fashion. And I guess even now you've become an author. And we're all targeted toward the same thing, and that's ensuring a bright future for the young people in our planet.
Okay, well, I think we all go along with that, Bill. We wish you all the very best for the rest of your mission. I tell you what, just before we go, can we see another of those somersaults?
Paul McCartney concert ticket, $100. ISS, $40 billion. Live concert, Paul McCartney on the space station, priceless.
I've got a feeling deep inside, oh yeah.
Oh yeah.
I've got a feeling I can't hide, oh no.
Oh no. Oh no.
number of different things, which I'm extremely proud of.
I've got tons and tons of McCartney here.
Nothing in that room. I'm prohibited from having Beatles in every room. I got a concert in Detroit on the 14th and in Columbus on the 22nd. I'm going to Las Vegas November 26th, so we're getting into McCartney mode. We'll worry about retirement a little bit later.
It's not like it's just adult music or just kids' music.
It's for everybody.
Okay, so here's your new Chaos in Columbus t-shirts. And Ashley, this one is yours. Now you'll see.
Line up.
Isn't it nice that six grandkids work out to
all of this
six
is his drawing.
Going to Paul McCartney!
We're here for the McCartney concert. Yeah. Thank you very much. I appreciate it. Here's a workstation right here, guys.
All right. I put it together, you glue it, okay?
Get that a little wet, it'll come off.
Make sure me is in the middle.
I'm on my second.
You're on your second already?
Yep.
I got two of them ready to go right here.
Help.
And you gotta make sure that you can just flip it.
Practice.
All right, we're done.
Here I know we're going there. Are we going to eat supper?
Which one is
it? There's a few things in life we're going to skip, and supper's one of them.
Grandma and I will be on either end of you guys.
Chaos.
Yes. I'm so excited. I love you.
We have one, two,
three.
Three generations.
Three generations. Our children and our grandchildren.
Who's going to introduce me? Nobody, I am.
There you go.
Dan.
How are you doing?
Oh, my God.
Oh my gosh. Just came in to say hi. How you doing?
You just don't know what this means to my husband. You just don't know.
Yeah, I do. Is this your husband?
Yes.
All right. How did I guess? Thought we'd come in and just surprise you.
Yeah, you definitely did.
Is that all yet? Yeah. Enough of you.
I think that's it.
Good to see you tonight. Yeah, I hope you enjoy yourselves
excellent
tonight. Okay?
We saw you in Detroit
last week. Look after it. Oh, you did?
Yes. Yes. Dan and I went to Detroit.
We were in Detroit last week.
They're gonna be in
and
Vegas.
We're going to see you in Vegas.
Are you?
We'll be in Vegas.
Let's party.
Okay.
Paul! My kids!
Bye, Paul!
Thank you.
Bye.
Thank you.
All right, see you. Bye-bye.
Are we on the inside?
Lord, I am now ready to go.
Follow me.
You lift up my spirits, you shine on my soul. Whenever I'm empty, you make me feel whole. I can rely on you to guide me through any situation. You hold up a sign that reads, follow me. You give me direction, you show me the way, you give me a reason to face every day. I can depend on you to send me any destination. You hold up a sign that reads, follow me, follow me. Down the track of loneliness, down the path of love, through the woods of heartache to the end. On the shores of song, where the waves crashing, the perfect place for me to find a friend. You lead me to places that I've never been, uncovering secrets that I've never seen. I can rely on me through any situation. You hold up a sign that reads, follow me.
In the audience watching the show was fantastic. And I was thinking to myself, why is he doing this? It occurred to me that he probably wanted to give some of us older people a chance to experience the performance of these songs by the guy that wrote them, maybe for the last time in our lives, and to give young people a chance for the first time in their lives, maybe the only time in their lives, to actually hear these songs by the person that wrote them. That really made me think of what it must have been like at a performance in a, you know, in a park on a Sunday to hear Bach playing his work on a harpsichord. You know, it was pretty great.
Like so many girls, Jenny Wren could sing, but a broken heart to curse all the way. Like the other girls, Jenny Wren took wood. She could see the world and its foolish ways.
Bummer, then I have to pretend like he's nice.
Maybe it's an act. Maybe it's not that nice.
We did have trouble, however, with the report of a girl in one of their rooms, that of Paul McCartney. They told us that Minneapolis was a very narrow-minded town, as were its police officials, and that other cities had been very tolerant to the parties that they had held in their rooms. One of their group with a British accent told me that they would never come back to Minneapolis, and I remarked to him that if they did not come, it would be too soon for me. This is a typical traveling troupe, much like you have with a circus, and that they are here today and they are gone tomorrow.
When I get to the bottom, I go back to the top of the side. When I stop and I turn and I go for a ride, till I get to the bottom, I see you again. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Do you, don't you want me to love you? Coming out fast, but I'm miles above you. Tell me, tell me, come on, tell me.
Songs that went through some instruments that were documented, recorded, and then sold and marketed on tangible, you know, objects. But
this music, his ideas, have transcended that and gone, and now they live inside of people's minds and their souls, so that now it can't die. It's immortal. It's going to keep moving forward. When you can do that, if a songwriter can do that, yes, that's a divine intervention. That's spirituality right there.
Yesterday, all my troubles seem so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Suddenly, I'm not half the man I used to be. There's a shadow. Suddenly, why she had to go, I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something wrong, now I long for yesterday. Yesterday, love was such an easy game. To hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday. Why she had to go, I don't know, she wouldn't say. I said something wrong, now I long for yesterday. Yesterday was such an easy game to play. Now I need a place to hide away. Oh, I believe in yesterday.
People have sung and talked about love, about peace, understanding, and people have talked about that for thousands of years. And I think whenever you get it, I think it works. We're at the moment, I think, you know, in particularly hard times, but I sort of think that that's part of the story, and that people's strength and people's humanity and people's common sense is going to prevail.
Paul McCartney's been an icon now for more than 40 years. He's been able to reach an enormous percentage of the world's people with a message that is universal. So many of his greatest songs are about personal experiences people can identify with, or emotions that are positive and good that we all ought to share.
How could anybody be angry at someone after that show? It just was such a powerful vibe.
I felt spiritually uplifted as I hadn't maybe ever been at a concert.
Just opening the floodgates emotionally and creatively and artistically and saying, let's all celebrate this together. And I mean it. I mean these songs. That's what I get seeing McCartney.
It's a visceral connection that can bring tears to your eyes and you don't know why. Inside, emotionally, there's no doubt what it means.
I think what makes Paul McCartney happier than anything is to see someone somewhere tapping their toes to something that he's written. And people like that bring joy to the world. I would assume that he's a man whose heart is filled with joy as well because of that.
He's given us a great gift, his lifetime of music and his generosity of spirit are a perfect blend, I think, for what the world needs today.
I think it's basically the same thing, that there's more than just this to our existence. Couldn't put a finger on it. I don't think I really would want to. It gives me faith that we're not just a bunch of mindless creatures stuck in this machine marched through the world, that we've got a great humanity and that a lot of us think alike. We have a lot in common with each other.